Hello, I'm Graham. Hope everyone's having a great day. Since I posted the sixth in the series of understanding the Panasonic Travel Zoom cameras, and in particular fitting a filter to that camera, there have been a couple of requests for details of how I actually fitted the 37mm filter to the front of the Panasonic Lumix TZ30. So this video is going to be a how-to video on how to modify the filtering itself to fit on the camera. I started off with a set of three 37mm filters which I bought on eBay, and they're from a company called Newer, N-E-W-E-R. They were a FLD filter, a circular polarizing filter, and a ultraviolet filter. I used the ultraviolet filter as the sacrificial mount for the rest of the lens system. There's actually no need to fit ultraviolet filters to modern digital cameras. You can use them to offer you a little bit of lens protection, but as the Panasonic Lumix has a shutter in there, I didn't feel there was the need. There's also the possibility you'll get reflections from the surface of the filter and it'll actually degrade your picture. So I decided to remove completely the filter from the filter mount. To do that, you have to remove a locking ring which holds the glass filter flat into the filter itself. The ring itself has got two fine slots in it, and you need to find some tool to enable you to put that tool into those slots to enable you to rotate this ring out of the filter adapter. In the past, I've used a pair of dividers which have a nice sharp point, and they will go into the two slots, enable me to rotate the filter locking ring out. I have used the scissors on other occasions, and I'll show you how to do that in this video. So to remove the filter locking ring from the filter itself, you need to put the point of the scissors into those two slots and hold the scissors at an angle so you can actually push and rotate that filter locking ring round. Once you get it started, it will come out fairly easily, but try not to mark the threads of the filter as you remove the locking ring. You'll find that once you've got the filter locking ring started, if you can get your fingernail under the filter, you can actually rotate the locking ring out of the filter holder and you'll not cause damage to the filter threads. So once you remove the locking ring and the filter itself, you have now the component which will then glue with double-sided tape to the front surface of the lens to give you the system which will hold other 37mm filters, or a 37mm to 49 or 52mm, whatever size of filter you want to put on the camera. In my original prototype, I decided to remove the rear threads of the 37mm filter to give me the slimmest possible filter mount that I could get away with. If you don't have the facilities to remove that back filter thread, I used a Dremel and a file, and then smoothed it down with some carborundum paper to get a real flat surface, then you can probably still use this 37mm threaded ring at the back, which will give you sufficient area to bond to the front. I'm going to try doing that with the ring now. In the original prototype, I used this 6mm or 1/4 inch wide double-sided tape, and it's as a protective layer. And what I did on the prototype was to stick small pieces of this around the outside edge of the filter and then cut them off until I had sufficient adhesive around the rim of this ring to be able to stick this to the camera itself. So I actually fitted six of these small pieces of double-sided tape around the outside of the lens. So once I've got the six pieces of tape around, it was a case of trying to trim this double-sided tape as close to the filter as possible. And then I removed the backing paper from the self-adhesive tape. It's probably the most trickiest part of the job. So now you're left with six adhesive pads on the ring, and it was a case of turning on the camera, letting the lens extend, and then positioning the filter ring on the lens itself and using the lens as a guide as to whether it was central. Then we can return the lens to the camera, and then I weighted this down for about an hour to allow the adhesive to cure and make a better bond to the lens. In the meantime, I found some wider double-sided tape. So what I'm going to try and do now is make a complete ring of adhesive material to achieve a better bond. So to do that, I'm actually going to cut two pieces of this. And stick them both together. So I've now got two pieces of self-adhesive with the protective film on either side. Let's remove these remnants of the demonstration piece. Now I'm going to draw round the inside diameter of the filter, and then using my scissors, I'm going to cut to the outside edge of that ring mark that I just made to give me the right diameter for the inside edge of the circular adhesive ring. So now I've got the central hole cut out, and I'm going to remove the adhesive backing from one side. And again, finding the adhesive backing is going to be the most difficult part of the job. Now I'm going to fit the ring onto the adhesive as centrally as I can and bond it down. And now I'm going to trim to the outside edge of that filter, again with the scissors, and trying to keep the scissors at an angle to get as close to the filter as I possibly can, so there's not much material left hanging over the edge of the filter. You'll find the adhesive tries to stick to your scissors, and then just trim it as close as you can to the outside edge of that filter, as you don't want any material going over the edge of the lens barrel. The neater you can get this, obviously, the better it will be on the camera. So as before, I'm going to power on the camera and now let the lens extend. Remove the protective film from the double-sided tape. Leaving the ring of adhesive on the filter mount, and again centralizing this over the lens. Then let the lens retract, and then weight it down for about an hour to allow that adhesive to cure. Try to get the filter as central as you can, and it will look much neater. Once that's cured, then you have that mount now for your additional 37mm filters. So there we are, that's the method I used to fasten the 37mm filter to the front edge of the camera using double-sided adhesive tape. So when you want to come to remove the filter ring, if you're going to resell your camera, then it's just a case of putting your fingernail between the filter and the lens and giving the filter holder a gentle twist, and it will come off without causing any damage. And if there's any residual adhesive on the front surface of the lens plate, just give that a wipe and it will come off cleanly. So there you are, that's my method of attaching the 37mm filter ring to the Travel Zoom camera. Hope you found that interesting, and it's Graham saying thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in later videos.